Hi, and welcome to The Tough Question, where we approach an expert with a head scratcher so you can better understand China. China understands that if it is to grow further, it must improve its state and governance systems. It is a challenging task, but the country's top leadership is up to it. In 2019, China laid out a roadmap for modernizing these systems and improving governance capacity. So what has China done and is planning to do to improve its state and governance systems? Here's Lin Yi from the School of Marxism at Tsinghua University.
State and governance systems. 中国的发展奇迹与治理成就令世界瞩目，而这一切又需要被追溯到中国的国家制度与治理体系的根源上去。具体而言，我们的国家制度与治理体系中需要完善之处表现在，作为一个拥有9000多万党员的世界最大执政党，中国共产党也面临着许多挑战，比如精神懈怠、能力不足、脱离群众、消极腐败等危险。 如何保证党员干部都有权为民所用的自觉？如何压缩腐败分子和懒政庸官的生存空间？如何适应不断变化的治理需求与条件等，都是摆在中国共产党面前的现实课题。再次，对于中国这样一个大国而言，治理规模的巨大与治理主体多元、治理层级繁多，往往会直接影响到制度优势转化为治理成绩的效果。中国治理体系的主要问题，往往都聚焦于基层。 一些好政策中央提出了正确的原则方针路线，但在实践中如何把原则制度化、法治化，如何尽可能减少在各个层级的损耗，就成为真正影响政策效果与群众反馈的关键。最后，我们在国内外理论界往往还处于话语权的弱势地位，面临着有理说不出、说理传不开的困境。很多事情。 我明明做好了，但却不知道做好的原因是立足中国道路，却以为这只是源于我们学习了西方的所谓成功经验。有时还会出现把中国的治理问题的根源归结到学习西方还不够彻底上去。可以说，中国实现治理现代化的目标改变至世界。而随着中国制度优势的进一步体现，那种把现代化等同于西方化、把西方制度视为对一切重大问题终极解决方案的神话，也必将走向终结。 而这便是中国制度实践的世界历史意义所在。When
it comes to the system of governance, one size doesn't fit all. The system has to be based on ground realities for it to benefit the people on ground. At the same time, one must adapt to changing times and innovate to ensure that one's growth is sustainable. After all, flowing water does not rot.